Hi everyone, welcome to you. In the last video we have learned the period, what's happening to the period if the angle becomes multiple or submultiple. I mean by multiple that x angle becomes 2x, 4x. Submultiple means x becomes x by 2 or x by 4. And we know how the period changes. The simple formula for that is 2 pi by a. If simple example for sine of ax plus b, so that's how you will get the period. And another way we know is the coefficient of the trigonometric function and the period of that particular function at 1x are inversely proportional. That means for sine x 2 pi. So if you want to find out sine 2x, if you are making it from 1 to 2, the period will go down by 2 because they are inversely proportional. So 1 became 2, 2 pi will become pi. If you multiply them, you will see that this is nothing but constant. Okay. Now we are more interested continuing that, and we want to know what happens if I add two functions like sine x plus 2a, sine 2x, or I subtract two functions sine 2x minus sine 4x, or if I multiply two functions, I say sine 2x into sine x, or if I divide two functions similarly, right? It's simply we are saying that there are two functions, trigonometric functions, fx comma gx. What will happen to the period? We have taken a simple example here. Now the blue line gives me the graph of sine x, and the pink line gives me the period of sine 2x. You can see that sine x period is 2 pi, whereas sine 2x period is pi. If you are adding these two, you are starting at 0. When you are meeting again, you are meeting only at 2 pi. That means the one which is having the larger period is dominating, or you are going for a common multiple of both here. Now the common multiple of here 1 and 2 is 2. That's why I know that after 2 pi they will be meeting again. So what happens to this graph we will see in the online tool, but what happens is every point this will be added to the blue. That means if I go here, the pink is 0, so it will be 0. If I go here to this blue line, this whole value at this particular moment will be added, it goes up. Similarly, if you look here to the blue one, you are actually subtracting the value. That means whatever the negative value, you will be going down here, but the shape will change, the period will remain as 2 pi. So to understand, if fx gx are two trigonometric functions and you are interested in finding out the period of them by doing arithmetical operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication or division, the period will be nothing but the common integral multiple or LCM of both the periods. It can be as complicated as something like this: sine 2x plus sine 3x divided by sine x plus sine 2x. The figure will change, but let us take this example, right? Now you know what is sine 2x period. Sine 2x period, according to us, is pi, because 2 into pi is pi. Sine 3x period, sine 3x is 2 pi by 3, because 3 into 2 pi by 3 is 2 pi. Sine x is 2 pi and sine 2x is pi. Now if I see here, pi and 2 pi by 3 here, and I have 2 pi and pi here. Now if I take all these from pi and 2 pi by 3, what is the common for them? Pi and 2 pi by 3, if I see, that is nothing but 1 and 2 pi 3. So if you see here, you have sine x and sine 2x. So what is the highest period of all of them? All of them is, this is nothing but equal to 3 pi by 3 in terms of pi by 3. This is 6 pi by 3 and this is 3 pi by 3. That means if this guy goes for 2, this guy goes for 3, this guy goes for 2, this guy will be completing only 1. That means he will be dominating. So 2 pi will be period of this function. You will be appreciate it more when we go through some examples. But let me take another simple example to just make sure that you got it right. What I am saying now is, if you take sine 2x plus sine 3x by sine x plus sine 2x, let us take these are two different trigonometric functions. We know sine 2x period is nothing but equal to pi, and sine 3x period is nothing but equal to 2 pi by 3. Sine x is 2 pi and sine 2x is pi. If you draw this graph, what happens? When you are trying to find out the period of all this, you have to look at where all these functions again meet. Suppose they are starting at 0. If you draw the curve, again where all these together will meet. That point is nothing but the common period, right? Because you are saying the period of the whole this expression. That means they should again meet. All of them should meet. Sine 2x is 3 pi by 3. Sine 3x is 2 pi by 3. Sine x is 2 pi, that's nothing but equal to 6 pi by 3. And sine 2x is 3 pi by 3. If I take sine 2x and draw 2 times, if I draw this 2 times, if I draw this 3 times, I mean to say the like this 1 and 2. Similarly, if I take this one and draw it 2 times, by that time sine x will complete 1 and come and join them. You got it? So what happens now? Sine x, which is having the most period, that will be dominating. So that will be the period of the whole this function. I think if we do some examples, then you will appreciate it. Just remember that if fx, gx are, it can be sine, cos, tan, whatever you want you can do. Only the thing is the logic will be the same. If fx, gx are two periods of trigonometric functions, if you are applying any arithmetical operation on them, like addition, subtraction, multiplication or division, the period of the function, the period of the total function will be nothing but equal to the common integral multiple of both of them. That means in this case, suppose I take sine 2x is, what is the period of sine 2x? Sine 2x period is pi. What is the period of sine 4x? Sine 4x period is pi by 2. Pi and pi by 2. What is the common multiple for them? Pi. Because 2 pi by 2. Pi by 2 into 2 equal to 2 pi by 2. So I know that pi is the period for that. Let's go to the online tool and stop here and go to the tool and see. You will appreciate that. When I was studying almost 27 years back, we don't have enough technology to substantiate that this is how it, this is the theory part. Let's go to the practical and see like really how the graph looks like. We have somebody's help that we have an online tool where I can go and draw the graph and I can see how this graph looks like. Now we know that pi equal to 3.14, that's nothing but 2 pi equal to 6.28. keep it in mind and we are going to do some examples. Okay, be focused here because this is very crucial and it is not covered much in any textbook to understand in detail. So suppose sine x, we know what is the period of sine x. Sine x period is 2 pi. Sine x period is 2 pi. 2 pi means 6.2. So where is the period now? If I start here, again I am getting here. That means one interval is over. That means these two difference is the period for me. So I will check the period. If you can see here, that is x equal to 8 and this is x equal to 14.3. That means 2 pi, 2 into 3.14, approximately 6.3. Now you want to cross check that. Let us make it as x by 2. Let us see what happens. If x by 2, what should be the period? The period should be 4 pi. 4 pi should be 12.56. So it's something like 3.6 here, and you can see here, 15.9 and some 3.3. You can see that it's nothing but equal to 4 pi. Now what happens if I make it as 4? If I make it as 4, it will be more. So you can see here, this should be approximately 25. I have minus 18 and here plus 6. That means it's coming around 25. So you can see now how the sine is behaving. Similarly, you can check for cos and tan also. Now we are interested what happens if I add two functions, right? That's what is stopping us. So let us take that and say that suppose I want to find out the period of sine x plus sine 2x. You know that the period of sine x is 2 pi and sine 2x is pi. When you draw these two, 2 pi and pi common multiple is 2 pi, so it should be 6.3. Let's check that. See, now you can see how the graph is completely changed. Okay, but the shape is changed, but the period remains of the sine x. You can see what is the period of sine x? 2 pi. 2 pi is nothing but 6.3. So if I go here, something like positive here, I have 7.4 approximately, and I have here 13.7. That means nothing but equal to 2 pi. Now if I make it as x by 2, it should become 12.6. Let's check that. If I check this, now you can check again. This is where I have the period. I am starting here and I am again getting here. So if I check that, this is 4 and this is equal to 16.5. That's nothing but 4 pi. Now you can see very clearly how the graph is behaving when you are adding them. Suppose you can subtract and see that also, the period will not change, the shape will change. Again you will have 12.56. You can check that. Now suppose I do that, this is 2.8 and this is 15.4, 15.1 and this is 2.6. So you can see that there is a 4 pi. Now we are interested in finding out what will happen if I multiply them. So let us say that I want to, let's do them one by one. I will say sine 2x. Okay, first we will do for sine 2x. Or we will do for sine 2x. We know sine 2x, what is the period? Sine 2x period is 3.1. So I should have 4.2 and 7.3. You see that there is a pi. Sine 2x is pi. Now I want to multiply this. I want to multiply this with sine of x. That means 2 pi, there is a period, and I am multiplying with pi period. According to the rule, whatever we have learned, either whatever the operation you are doing on it, you should have a common multiple. This is 2 pi and this is pi. That means by the time this guy goes for 2 rounds, this guy completes only 1. That means this is 0.28. Let us check that. So if you can see here, the symmetry, so nice, right? Looks very exciting. Now I know that my period starts here and again it ends here. That means this is the period. That means the curve, one repetition, starts here and ends here. If I take this as 5.4 and this is 11.7, you can see that is nothing but equal to 2 pi. So whatever you multiply with, suppose you make it as 3x, the shape will change, but it will be 2 pi only because sine x dominates. You can see the difference here, but that there will not be any difference in the whole this thing. Sine x, you know, is 2 pi. So if I start here, 2.7, and again I see here. So where I am starting and where I am coming, that's where I have to be very clear. So if I am starting from here, I am completing this whole part and I am coming here. That means you can see that's nothing but equal to 2 pi. The shape is changing, but the period remains the same. Let's continue this. Let us say sine 3x. Let's make it a little bit big. So I will say sine 3x. Okay. Let's do for sine 3x. Okay. If I do sine 3x, we know that the period is 2 pi by 3. 2 pi by 3 is nothing but equal to approximately 2. So I should have 2 as the period here. That means if I start from here, I go to the next, the period is nothing but equal to 2. You can see that 2.8 to 4.8, 5 to 3 approximately. So you can see that it's a 2. Now suppose I want to add to this sine of 2x. Now let us see what happens. First we will check for sine 2x separately so that we can. Sine 3x, we have found that the period is 2. Now let us do for sine 2x. Sine 2x, we know period is pi, that means 3. Sine 2x, we know very clearly the period is pi. 10.4, 13.8. So this is 13.8. I mean, I think you cannot get the exactly when I'm going so fast, but you can focus and keep it there. You can see that this is pi. So 1 is 2, 1 is 3. If I'm adding them, what will happen to them? Now 2 and 3, what is the common multiple? 2 and 3, what is the common multiple? The common multiple for 2 and 3 is 6. That means the period should be, let's check this here. If I'm starting here, 7, 6, 7, and see here, 6. You can check that. So what I'm trying to say here, sine 2x and sine 3x, I'll come back here. So that example, what I'm trying to say there is, see here, same thing. Sine 2x by sine 3x, we have coincidentally taken the same example. Sine 2x, the period is nothing but pi. Let us say approximately 3. Sine 3x, the period is approximately 2 pi by 3. 2 pi by 3, approximately I'll say 2. This period is 3, this period is 2. They're starting at 0. When they will again meet, this guy will go for 2 rounds. 2 into 3 equal to 6. This guy will go for 3 rounds, 2 into 3 equal to 6. That is where they will meet again. Again at 6 only they will meet. That means 6 minus 0 is nothing but the period of this function. I hope this is very clear. So what I am trying to say here is, when you have two functions like this, you have to go for a common multiple of the both the periods. The whole idea, if you understand the graph, is where you are meeting again. Because the whole function has to repeat for the period, right? Whole function has to repeat. That means both of them together should repeat again. So you can experiment this. You can actually note down this URL also. This is pretty much nice. You can do lot of experimentation by putting all the values whatever you want. Not only that, from your textbook, whatever the problems you have, you can put it down here. It allows all trigonometric functions, whatever you want. And you can check that. Now let's do the couple of last examples. I will say I want sine 2x plus sine x. I know that the period of this is nothing but equal to, this is pi, this is 2 pi, so it should be 2 pi. That's nothing but equal to 6.2. So 7.5 and 7.2. And you can see that this is nothing but equal to 2 pi. That means I am starting from here, I am completing one time over here, and again I am repeating that. You can see this is so nice, beautiful. Okay, now let's try to divide this whole thing. I will say I want to divide this whole thing and see how the graph changes. Graph should not change whatever I do at the bottom unless that period is more. So I say sine of x plus sine of 4x. The graph period will not change because for 2x, 4x, and 2x period is pi, x is 2 pi, 4x is pi by 2, the common multiple is 2 pi. So it should be remain as 6.3. Okay, this is a little bit tough to understand. I agree, but you can see actually, if I take one point here, that is minus 3.3, and again I check here, you can see that the symmetry is 2 pi. The way the graph shape is changed, but the period will not change. Now if I divide only with sine x, the graph will change, but the... I did some blunder, I'll just fix it. Okay, right. So the graph will be same, 6.3. You can check here, minus this is 3.3 and this is 9.6. So you can see that the graph will not change. I hope that explained you a little bit about what happens to the period of the functions whenever you try to add, subtract, multiply and divide. Unfortunately, I seen lot of textbooks. This was covered a little bit in couple of lines, but it was not exactly told in a simple manner. So I just thought, let me do experiment a little bit on that, research in the net and try to find out. Luckily I found this tool with the help of which I was able to explain you how everything is going on. So you can go ahead and experiment here and try to understand how the period changes. Now you see that the periods are so easy because now you know what is the secret behind that. So see you in the next video, where we'll go to the compound angles and we'll continue the trigonometry topic. But we'll be done with the periods for now. We will come back when we go a little bit advanced in the trigonometry. Thanks for visiting. Bye for now. See you in the next video.